are we going to use robots to solve our problems? Are they going to create problems, particularly around the public good or the common good?
Well, I'm happy to be here with Dr. Nidhi Kalra. Nidhi is the Senior Tech Policy Advisor for Senator Kamala Harris of California, but she's also an expert in decision making under deep uncertainty. And that sounds super scary to me. Tell me about it.
You know, the idea is we often think about planning in a few years ahead or a few moments. What happens when we can't really see a clear picture of the future? How do we make decisions today that will have important repercussions 50 years, a century later, and we have no idea what that world looks like? Often when we can't see that clear future, we try to pretend like the problem doesn't exist. You know, take climate change, for example.
Okay, great use case.
And the question is, can we do smart things today that make long-term sense? Can we make good decisions without good predictions?
So is that looking at both how humans make decisions and, you know, building models? Or like, what goes into informing what you just described?
You know, it's a way of thinking. First and foremost, it's a way of thinking, and then you bring the tools, the technology into play. Is there something I can do today that I will not regret no matter what the future brings?
That's a huge question.
Right? But yeah. I'll tell you there are. Again, using the example of climate change, getting off of fossil fuels, when would we regret that? Whether or not climate change is real, which it is, right? We will not regret the energy independence. We will not regret the clean air. We will not regret the preservation of our lands. We will not regret the inexpensive, distributed, resilient, for example, solar and wind. That's a great idea. I don't need to look 100 years into the future to know that's a great idea now.
How do you get people into that mindset?
You know, you remind them this is how they make decisions every single day. They just don't think about it. This is actually very human to think about no regret decisions. For example, you know, your kid is thinking about their future. They're in high school. We send them to college if we can, because we know that no matter what happens, that's probably going to be a good
bet, right?
We don't say, well, you know, what about 30 years later when you want to do this very specific thing? We say, this is a good idea. Go. We try to think this way when we, you know, when we take a job, when we choose our spouses. This is the way we are naturally oriented, right? And we forget that when we're trying to solve engineering or policy problems. Then we demand certainty.
If I'm thinking 3 years in advance from now, what policy challenge, and it doesn't have to be AI related, but what policy challenge do you think is on the forefront of the three-year from now future?
You know, I think the conversation that is getting a lot of attention is an algorithmic justice.
Okay.
You know, how we've ridden this wave of, oh my gosh, we suddenly have neural networks that can do deep learning. How are we going to use them? And now we're realizing, oh, how are we going to use them responsibly, fairly, to achieve our goals and actually our values, right? Not just an end for themselves. And I think that's where we're going to have a lot of conversation about how we create transparency in our algorithms. How do we measure fairness? What does fairness even look like when we have trouble figuring it out in our world? One of the first places to start is to remember that when we bring AI into social and economic systems, we are talking about real people. And I would actually start there.